What's up, everybody? It's your boy Cracker Jack from the 209 giving you something a little bit different this time. This is a game that I've played mostly on the PC since Diablo 1. Now, I've played all the way through the PC. This on course is not the PC. This is Diablo 3 for the PS4. Now, when you look up YouTube videos on these things, you always see these badass characters, these guys that are doing the Greater Rifts 95 and up. And you know what? I take nothing from them. They are badass characters. They spent a lot of time and put a lot of effort into building those characters to get that high. Me personally, I have not cleared anything higher than a 66 yet. But still, they are badass characters. I'm not taking anything from them. However, all these characters you see have ancient legendary armor and weapons and rings and amulets, and everything has been augmented. Now, for those of you that don't know what that is, you have your sets of armor. You have normal. You have elite. You have legendary. You have ancient legendary. And there's one more in there I'm missing. It's the blue one. I forget what it is. I think it's rare. But anyways, so your ultimate goal is to end up with legendary so you can make ancient legendary armor, and that's the best you can get. Now, an augmentation is where you can add stuff to the armor to make it even more powerful, giving you more damage, more defense, whatever. And you can augment only ancient legendary items. So, with that being said, they have put a lot of time in the hardest difficulty on this game, which is Torment 10. Farming and planning and doing the hell rifts to be able to augment all that armor and to find it just to begin with. So that's not what I'm here to do today, guys. I'm here to show you how you can take a level 70 character and just by finding the items, they don't even have to be the greatest stats on the items, but just finding the items, you'll be able to play in Torment 10 and be able to farm for the stuff to do what these other guys are doing in the higher greater rifts. So with that being said, like I said, I'm here to show you how to do it. Just some things that I've put together that have worked really well for farming Torment 10 right off the bat with nothing, no paragons, nothing more than your normal gems that you can build and the armor itself. So let's go ahead and start. Okay, so here we are. This is my favorite Demon Hunter to play. This is the Unhallowed Essence, the shotgun Demon Hunter build. Badass bitch of all time. She's my favorite out of the Demon Hunters to play. Now, this build is pretty much basic. Let's go ahead and go over the armor. Your weapon you're going to be looking for is a Yang's Recurve, which does multi-shot, attacks 50% faster. Now, multi-shot is going to be your main bread and butter. So, this weapon is a must. You have Dead Man's Legacy, which allows multi-shot that hits enemies below 52% health twice. Beautiful! So now you're doing double the hits when you get them that low. It does rely on the Unhallowed Essence set, which normally revolves with the feet, the pants, the hands, shoulders, chest, and normally you go with the helm as well. Now, the difference is I am running a Visage of Goons, or however you want to pronounce it, because I do stay in Vengeance mode 24/7, and I will go over that in just a minute with you. With this helm, I get the Dark Heart rune, which increases my defense dramatically. Like, just skyrockets my defense up as long as I'm in Vengeance mode. So, I opted to get the extra defense here. You don't have to. You can complete the set and not have to rely on the Royal Ring of Granger like I am. But if you do want the extra defense, especially in the higher greater rifts, in order to be able to just take that extra hit or two, I would suggest running a Royal Ring of Granger with this helm. That being said, I use a Nemesis Bracers because this is mainly a farming chick. I have gone higher into the greater rifts, up to about 61 with her right now. There are better wraps if you want more defense, like the Wraps of Clarity. That would give you another defense buff. But mainly, this is my farming lady. Like, I run through hell rifts with her and just trash mobs. I kill people long before I even see them on the screen. And because of that, I run the Nemesis Bracers, which allows me to, every time I hit a shrine, spawn either a champion or an elite, which gives me more death breath and a higher chance of getting the legendaries that I need dropped from them. I run a witching hour belt. Now, this is kind of open. I've seen people run the witching hour. I've seen them run other belts as well. Off the top of my head, I couldn't tell you what they were. This is kind of just your opinion. What belt do you have that is the best that suits the needs of what you're doing? You know what I mean? I like the witching hour because it does have the attack speed. It does have the critical hit damage on it. So I personally like the witching hour, but that's really up to you. You will need a hellfire amulet. Now, with the Hellfire Amulets, the stats you really want to focus on is your main damage point, which dexterity, as much critical hit chance and critical hit damage, plus an extra passive skill that you are going to use. That's the main key things on your Hellfire Amulet. This I am running just because I have not found a decent Stone of Jordan for her yet. At least not one that compares to this Averis Band. So, I'm running this Averis Band for the gold pickup. I also have a level 50 Boon of the Hoarder legendary gem in it. That is the only legendary gem I have in. I solely use that for money. It does nothing for my attack, it does nothing for my defense. But because of this gem, as you can see to the left, just below my character's stats and everything, I have 1,309 million. I am raking in the gold because of this gem alone. And the nice thing is I can give gold to my friends if they need it, if they go broke. So I always run this. Convention of Elements is a damage boost that no character should go without in this game. It is just too much of a boost to pass up for any of the characters. So Convention Elements, in my personal opinion, is an absolute must. So once again, the belt is kind of up to you. It's whatever you have that's really good. The Yang's Recurve is a must. Dead Man's Legacy is a must. The Unhallowed Essence set is a must. And if, like I said, if you want the extra defense buff, go ahead and run the Royal Ring of Granger in your cube slot, like I am, which I'll cover that once I get to the skills. And put on a Visage of Goons. It's a nice little defense buff. The Hellfire Amulet, Nemesis Bracers to help you just get that extra Death's Breath and the extra legendary so you can get the Forgotten Souls. And yeah, I believe that's it for the armor. Now, before I pass on the armor and go to the skills, there is two things that I need to focus on here. If you notice with my chest piece here, I'm going to scroll down. The 9 to maximum discipline. That is essential. Especially when you see this gold rim around the border of the armor itself as you're looking. Where it says Cage of the Hellborn, you're looking at the armor right there to life. It's got 747 armor numbers. You see that gold rim? That is an ancient legendary. That is what you are looking for to be able to get into those higher rifts. Now, when it comes to finding that stuff, you need to focus on two stats for this build. The first being the maximum discipline. With this build, maximum discipline is where you get all of your damage from, every bit of it. Thanks to the armor bonus, your generators, multi-shot, and vengeance deal 40% increased damage for every point of discipline. So that is a huge buff right there. So in situations like with the armor here, I believe my weapon. Yep, I got 12 to maximum discipline right there on my weapon. On my quiver, I've got another 12 to maximum discipline. Anytime you're gonna change a stat, always look for the maximum discipline first. Because that, like I said, that's where you get all your damage. The second stat, which is key and must, that you do need for this build, is about a 40% or as close to it in cooldown reduction. Now, the reason you need that 40% is because that's going to make it to where you can stay in your vengeance constantly, which is something that is very key to this build. So, in situations like where I've got on my gloves, I've got reduced cooldown, I've got reduced cooldown on my shoulders, you need a 40%. Other than that, it's your basic Demon Hunter. You want to run about a 50% critical hit chance, or as close to it. As much critical hit damage, attack speed is light, is nice, but it's not a necessity. Make that about a fourth requirement. You do need the cooldown reduction to about 40%, which you see I've got mine at 37.33 without my Paragons. Now you see I have Paragon levels. I'm 676, but I have got none of them on. I've stripped all my Paragon points so that you guys can see that with this build, you don't need them. You just complete the armor and normal gems in it, and you can go out and kill. and be able to start farming and everything else that you need to be able to build these characters that we're watching and thinking are so badass on YouTube. Let's go ahead and move on to the skills. Evasive fire with focus. Now, if you cannot stay in Vengeance constantly or you're not spamming your multi-shot just right, you are going to start using your hatred. That's where this skill comes into play. This is what you are going to use to just help you replenish that hatred as quickly as possible so you can go back to hitting your main damage. Multi-shot is the bread and butter of this. Now, some people say you can use full broadside here for the increased damage, which you can, but I find it drains your hatred a lot faster, and here's the reason why. I use Arsenal, which changes multi-shot to a fire skill. Now, with that being said, in my cube, you see, I run a Dawn. That reduces the cooldown of Vengeance by 65%. That is a must-have. For my armor slot, I run the Cindercoat, reduces all the resource costs of my fire skills by 30%. So by putting multi-shot to arsenal and changing it to a fire skill, I have now reduced the cost of casting that ability by 30%, which makes it to where I can shoot it off a lot longer than somebody running the broadside multi-shot. And of course, in my ring slot, as I said, I run the Royal Ring of Granger because I run the Visage of Goons, the Helm. I do run Vault because this is a ranged character. You do not want to be close with this build. Okay, the further you are away, especially when you get the Legendary Stone that I will talk about, range is key for this build, okay? So I use Vault, but I don't want to use my Discipline on it, so I use the Acrobatics Rune, which removes the Discipline cost, but it does add a cooldown. Now, if you can get your cooldown reduction to the 40%, it's only about 2.5 seconds. That's all the cooldown is. You can use it fairly fucking quick still, but it doesn't take for my Discipline, which is where my damage sits. Preparation with Invigoration, the first rune, and the reason why is because it permanently increases maximum Discipline, which does what? Jumps up our damage. So this is a damage buff. Same thing as Companion, Wolf Companion. You get a 30% damage increase for 6 seconds when you use this. So you have two damage buffs that you can activate one right after another if you really want to wipe the floor with somebody. And of course, Vengeance. Now with Vengeance, we are using Seethe for the increased hatred regeneration. Once again, very key on making sure we can spam our multi-shot with that. For passives, I run Thrill of the Hunt, which does trigger one of the legendary gems as well, called Bane of the Trapped. But we won't cover that. We won't get into that just yet. I'll cover that in a minute. Ballistics for the increased rocket damage. Why? Because our arsenal uses homing rockets. So it makes them stronger and it has a chance of throwing out an extra rocket out there. I run Leech for the life per hit. You are hitting so many people and so fast and rapid of a succession that you steal life like nobody's business. And Ambush for a nice little damage buff for enemies above 75%. So once again, we have Evasive Fire with Focus, Multi-Shot with Arsenal. We have Vault with Acrobatics, Preparation with Invigoration. We have Companion with Wolf Companion, Vengeance with Seethe. For passives, we run Thrill of the Hunt, Ballistics, Leech, and Ambush. And in our cube, we do have a Dawn, a Cindercoat, and the Royal Ring of Granger. So, we have gone over the armor, we have gone over the skills, we have gone over the fact that I am not running any Paragons to show you guys that this build is just that easy to put together and just to be able to go out and farm. For when you do start finding the stuff that you do want to keep and use, the gems that I have come to know, Xayah Stone of Vengeance is a must. Massive damage boost, especially with this build, and this goes back to what I was saying is key about being a ranged character, okay? For every 10 yards between you and the enemy you hit, your damage is increased by 8%, up to a maximum of 40% at 50 yards, with a 20% chance on hit to stun the enemy. Now, like I said, this thing scatters across the screen. You'll notice people dropping that ain't even on your screen. You'll pull up your map and you'll see a legendary in an area you haven't even gone yet. So the spread of your multi-shot is insane. And with this stone alone, it makes it a huge damage buff. Now, Bane of the Trapped, when you get this to 25, increases the damage against enemies under control impairing effects by 22.5%. When you get it to 25, you gain an aura that reduces the movement speed of enemies within 15 yards. But wait a minute, within 15 yards? I thought I said to stay away. Oh, that's right, that goes back to our skills. Enemies hit by a hatred spender are now slowed by 80% for 2 seconds, which is what? A control impairing effect. So anybody you hit with your multi-shot, because it is a hatred spender, now gets slowed, which in fact triggers our Bane of the Trap to giving you that 22.5% damage increase. Now when I do find a Stone of Jordan, I will be running Bane of the Stricken, just because every attack you make against an enemy increases its damage by 1.05%, which doesn't seem like a lot, but you know what, in those harder enemies to fight where it does take a couple of shots, each shot is going to increase that damage, making it to where you're doing it more and more and more, and you're dropping them faster. You also gain a nice little 25% increased damage to all bosses and Rift Guardians, which, let's face it, 25% is 25%, people. You ain't gonna pass that up. So, I have gone over the legendary gems that you are probably gonna wanna run. If you decide you wanna run something different and you find out that it works, you know, a little bit better, hey, leave me a message. I'd like to try it out, you know, see for myself. But these are what I run personally. I've gone over the inventory. I've gone over the skills. I've gone over the stats. I've shown you that there's no paragons. So what do you say we do a little live gameplay so you guys can just get a feel for this character and see that I'm not just talking out my ass? So we activate our Vengeance. have proven your... So there you guys have it. It's that simple. It's that easy. It takes no real, like, complications or, oh, I gotta do this. All you do is you just watch your hatred and everything else. So if you guys like, subscribe. I will be posting more up. I've got 4 more characters that I'd like to get on here to show y'all just how to farm Torment 10 and have a good time playing the game. So hit me up if you guys like it, and try it out for yourselves. All right.